Top of the order here. Top of the order. What?
Are you taking the space off here? On what?
The face off.
You what?
You're good player.
I never said you were bad.
I fit the league, so I'm probably going to win it.
Let's get you here, guys. Let's get you.
Okay?
All right.
Santa on the receiving end from Getzlaf. Bounces in front. Bobby Ryan gets a stick on it, has it slashed away. Looks around, palms skyward as if to say, why is that not a penalty? And then just pushes anybody who comes near him as he tries to kick at it in the corner.
Minty Bietta is pushing Bobby Ryan's stick back towards him.
Yeah, that was strange. Ludman with a shot. Rebound! Bobby Ryan scores! And give an assist to Mietman because the stick was right there for Ryan to pick up.
But Antti Mietman was nice enough to push it over towards him. There it is at his feet so that he could pick it up. And when the rebound came his way, the plot is thickening here, folks. So he actually scored that goal with Mikko Koivu's stick, and that's why he was showing the shaft of the stick at the end. So let's take one more look. So here's Bobby Ryan. Stop it here. In comes Koivu, and he's going to say, I'm going to take your stick. So this is why Bobby Ryan was upset there was no penalty call. So he's got Bobby Ryan's stick. Antti Mietman, now I know why he's sweeping the stick towards the corner, because he thinks that Koivu's going to get it back. Instead, this is unbelievable.
You remind me of Lieutenant Columbo right now.
Go away.
It's a two-goal lead now. Sutter from Cook and Martin at 19:26 as Marchand shoots and scores. Welcome to the game, Marc-Andre Fleury. And just after
the inspiration from his team, here was earlier Cook and Marchand going at each other, a little hack and whack. Well, instead, what does that do? Well, Marchand, you've seen it, beats Cook to the outside. And this one up and over the goaltender. Fleury in, gets beat early.
25 seconds after the goal.
For Bailey, his shot scores! Josh Bailey!
Well, one way you want to become public enemy number one is do this. They're not going to appreciate it. I'm sure McElhinney didn't appreciate it either.
The Carolina Hurricanes are going to the Eastern Conference Final.
For themselves. Here's a chance. Eiserman! Oh, he just couldn't finish it off as Wall was down. Eiserman in front again. Another chance and a big stop. And the puck's in. Wall had it and dropped it. And Detroit scores first for the first time.
Patrick Wall just got caught hot dogging. Believe me, he was going to give it the how do you do, and he dropped the puck.
Steve Eiserman with the first chance, and Blink saved the day for the Avalanche. Now Eiserman's late getting out of the corner because he just gets behind the defense. Now watch why. He's got it. And then he drops it. And he thinks he's got it in his glove, and I'm not so sure he was giving it the old, look what I got. Let's have a... Yep.
Taken away from Hartikainen, and the Hawks get it in.
Nick Leddy can go for a change.
That's gonna be a suspension. Danny Carcillo put Gilbert badly into the end boards, and Dan Carcillo is gonna have a meeting with Brendan Shanahan. And Carcillo looking as if he may need some attention as well. He's having trouble with one of his legs, it looks like.
We'll just have to wait and see, but as Gilbert goes hard into the boards, he comes back and falls on Carcillo's leg. It's his left knee ends up grabbing. And unfortunately, you can't hit a guy when he hasn't touched the puck yet. 5-minute major to Daniel Carcillo, so a huge power play for Edmonton.
Marcello, you could see, I think, could not put any weight on his left leg. Gilbert also left the game and went to the Oilers' dressing room. Here's the shot, handled by Crawford, rebound loose, back to the blue paint, they whack, they score, and the Oilers score right away on the 5-minute power play, which of course...
Certainly factor into the decisions. A lot of the conversation around Chris Kreider, what the Rangers will do with him. Pastrnak has it with some space now. Pastrnak got it to Krug, but not cleanly. Deflected in front. Oh. And a good save by Georgiev.
Great save.
Bergeron was there in front. Oh, we got a little fisticuffs.
Go back
after
to
the dramatic drop.
Remember the first period, Marchand and Lindgren.
Yep. A little bit of theatrics after the physicality.
That 1-0
sure was, and you don't usually see Bergeron get involved, but when he does get involved, you know you're going to have other Bruins who come to his rescue, right? Because
only Marchand, 2 for Krawczyk at 17-14, so the Rangers 0-2.
Sid the Kid acting like one. Watch Ilya Kovalchuk. Ah, he was going to retaliate. Doesn't. Give him a little shot. Shot back. Slash. Whack hack. Now what? Trash shot. Ilya Kovalchuk goads Crosby into a penalty. So you want to talk about one guy being 22, one being 18. The 18-year-old looked like the youngster. Gesticulating and some sitting again.
He's not going to get those calls, too. He's not making friends with the officials. I mean, he's got to improve on that.
Yeah, and I don't know. Maybe that's just part of his personality. It's weird because he's such an even-tempered, quiet kid.
Far side to Modri. Remember, though, whether Gretzky was like that when he was that young. I know it was later. Here's Hossa holding it. Far side. Kovalchuk beats it. Scores again. Kovalchuk.
Don't forget, I think this all stems from, remember the hit, watch his point. He's pointing right to him. Ah, it's awesome. He's telling him. And you know why? The hit in the first period, Crosby on Kozlov, Slava Kozlov. Ilya Kovalchuk from that point forward. Listen, they're still chirping at each other.
Against Colorado, and I think it was Alex Tanguay tried to turn around and ice the puck. I think we're on the power play, and clipped me with a high stick.
Wow! Hurt right in the mouth.
I was slowly going to the bench with my trainer, and a fan who was sitting right on the glass started to heckle me, and just started calling me some names and that I really can't say on TV.
Watch Patrick Watt. I watch the puck as it goes around. Bonk! It hits something. And now Sullivan comes over. This is the fan, the same fan who was giving Sullivan a hard time. And that's his wife laughing with the thumbs up.
And luck be it, Patrick Roy got the puck behind the net and threw it over the glass, and it clipped the same fan right in the forehead, and he started bleeding probably worse than I was. And Antonio Monte yelled at me on the ice that it was the same fan, so I just took it upon myself to go back and tell him a few words of my own, and you know, I think his girlfriend thought it was pretty funny.
Maybe one last gasp here for the Oilers. Bergeron fans on a pass, Stefan steals, and he'll ice it. Oh, at least I thought he was gonna, until he blew it. That's unbelievable. Here come the Oilers the other way, and Hemsky's loose. Hemsky, he scored! Can you believe what we just saw?
Patrick Stefan, you should be embarrassed for what you just did. And then the puck is turned over, stolen. Gets the puck up, and shockingly, it's Ryan Smith. Alex Hemsky makes a remarkable move, and the Oilers somehow are going to send this game to overtime.
Going on here between Beaton
and Secord.
As the fans are now getting involved. As O'Reilly is out into the stands, and this is going to be something. O'Reilly's into the stands fighting with a Ranger fan, and all the Bruins are going over. Gilbert is in there, Peter McNabb. They're all into the stands. McNabb's going up to grab somebody about 7 or 8 rows up.
Well, this is too bad that after the game is over, it gets out of hand like this. And you got to worry about a spectator.
Well, the Bruins are at a decided disadvantage, Fred, with those skates, and somebody could get seriously hurt.
Oh, this does the game no good at all.